Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well today, and I'd like to welcome my new subscribers. Thank you for subscribing, I love having you all. So this is What's Their Karma for Hurting You? Pick a card reading. So with card one we've got Carnelian, which is the orange stone there, and the card is Masquerade. So that's for pile one. For pile two we have Jade. And we have Blinded by Pain. And then pile three, we have Amethyst. And the card is Naked Before the Stars. So what I'm going to do is you pick your pile. And I'm going to look into who this person is more in depth. And what they did. And then what their karma is, okay? So don't forget, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. And don't forget their energies as well, guys. So if it's not your pile, choose another pile. I'll see you at your piles. Hey, pile one. So if you chose Carnelian, heart there, and the card Masquerade. So with this card, the overall energy of this person that hurt you is this person wore a mask, you know, hence the name Masquerade. They were wearing a mask. It could even be a friendship, a relationship, you know, it could even be, I wouldn't say parent, but we'll dig into who this person is. So this is someone, could have been wearing a mask in a relationship, you know, showed one side of themselves to you, but really it wasn't their true self. So let's have a look at who this energy is here. So spirit angels, ancestors, tell me about this masquerade. Who is this energy here and what did they do to my pile ones? What about this masquerade card here? Who is this and what did they do? You know what, past couple of days of doing readings, the energies are very stubborn. It's like they don't want to reveal anything. There we go. Finally. So this is, we've got the Eight of Cups, the Tower, Five of Swords, Ace of Pentacles. I want four more cards. So tell me more about this energy here. What did they do to my pile ones? Okay. Queen of Pentacles, Ten of Pentacles, a lot of pentacles here. Nine of Pentacles. Just get one more card, guys. I think I'm seeing, I can sort of see what's going on here. One more card, please. Okay. We've got three more cards. Page of Swords. Okay. So, part one, you had to walk away from this energy here. Because Eight of Cups is leaving something behind, a lot that you've invested in, and you know there's a lot of pentacles here, so you invested a lot of energy and a lot of finances as well was invested in this relationship. Okay, the foundation that you thought that you would, you know the life that you thought you had built with this person came crumbling down because it was all a lie. You know, the Tower is all about truths being revealed to you. And this is what this card speaks of up here. It's a masquerade. It's wearing a mask. It's a manipulator. It's someone that doesn't show their true selves. And I feel like something was revealed to you. So now, because this was revealed to you, you had to walk away from this person. You know, you had to admit that this wasn't going to go anywhere. And it even could be because you needed to protect your income, or, you know, because we've got the Ten of Pentacles here. Ten of Pentacles is generational wealth. So it could be that you were handed down an inheritance here, is what I'm getting for you, pile one. And I'm getting strong energy vibes here from this energy here, is that they were using you for what they could get out of you, because you've got the Ace of Pentacles, you've got the Ten of Pentacles here. You know, your Nine of Pentacles is you doing very well for yourself. You know, you were single, you are single now. Look, Queen of Pentacles, you are someone that is so successful. It could even be that you've made your own success, pile one. You could have been married to this person, or it could have just been a high level commitment here. You know, like you've been together for a long time and you committed to this person. But there was a lot of worry in this connection here when you were with this person. They caused a lot of stress, a lot of burdens. They made you worry. It could be that they were spending money. You know, tell me about this tower. Okay, I feel for most of you, take what resonates, it doesn't matter. It could have been that you were in a serious commitment, whether you were married or not, but I do believe you were married to this person. But this wealth, excuse me, comes from you, not from them, okay? Now, what was revealed to you was that this person, for a very long time, that you may not have been aware of it, what they were doing was giving to other people, giving to somebody else. So they were taking your wealth and, you know, giving it to whoever. I'm going to clarify that. And they were doing this for a very long time. We've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy here. We've got a lot of Taurus. We've got a lot of earth sign here as well. And we've got, Taurus, a lot of earth sign here, guys. Like earth energy, I mean, you know, earth signs, whatever. So, yeah, they were giving to somebody else, but who were they giving it to? Okay, tell me about the Six of Pentacles. Who were they giving to, Spirit? Oof. Wow, Three of Wands, the Star, Aquarius energy, Eight of Wands, Queen of Swords, air energy in here as well, a lot of air. Ooh, and the Devil. So yeah, we've got strong earth sign in here and strong air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. So who are they giving it to? I don't think they were giving it to anybody. I think they were giving it to themselves. I feel like they were, how can I phrase this? I feel like they were not money laundering, taking money from you and putting it in a separate bank account, if you get what I mean, pile one. So it's like they could have been working with you, but they were taking a little cut for themselves that you may not have noticed at the time. And this was going on for a very long time with this energy here. They were looking out for themselves with the Three of Wands here. They were waiting for the right opportunity to F you over, basically, you know? Because they had dreams, they had some kind of idea of what it was that they wanted to do with the finances. I feel like they really did want to leave you in poverty here. But they did it in such a clever way. And yeah, this masquerade here, this could have even been a business partnership as well, but I am picking up strong relationship vibes here. But also it could have been a business partnership, because that is like, when you're in a business partnership, it is like a marriage, isn't it? When you go into business with someone. So, you know, take what resonates. It could be that for you guys as well. Yeah, and I feel like you found out, when you found out with the Tower, that's something that happens very quickly, very abruptly. And with the Eight of Wands as well, I feel like you found out something. You may have seen a document somewhere. You may have seen a paper trail somewhere. And you took action very quickly here towards this person to protect what is yours, what you've worked hard for, or what was handed down to you. You know, you became very defensive with this person, but also because you are the Queen of Swords, which I love the Queen of Swords, you're very wise. You handled the situation very well here. You were very clever. You didn't show your hand. You didn't let this person know that you knew what they were doing. You bided your time. You know, you started to see through the lies, and that is the Queen of Swords. And you started to protect yourself as well. And then what you did to defeat the devil here, you took action. You brought about a big change. You know, you took a risk, and I feel like it did pay off. Tell me about the devil, please, Spirit. Tell me about the devil here. This has something to do with a lot of money or a business partnership here. Tell me about this devil. Here we go again, stubborn. Queen of Cups. Tell me more about the devil. Okay, that makes sense. So with the masquerade card as well, this card's meaning is this is like Casanova. This is someone that comes in as so charming, and they're very romantic, and they have the gift of the gab, and they manipulate women, or if it's a man, manipulate women. If it's a woman, she uses her body, you know, that kind of thing. So that's the masquerade here as well. Now, they manipulated you with the right words, with saying the right thing, you know, showing you how much they loved you, because that is the Queen of Cups. And don't forget, this is an energy here, so this can be male as well. The Queen of Cups is someone that is very loving, very warm, very kind, you know, they're loyal, they're, you know, they're just all about the love, but it was fake. It was a disguise, which literally clarifies the masquerade here and the devil card here with the Queen of Cups. It was literally just a masquerade, wearing a mask. It wasn't true. They were the devil underneath all that. Tell me more about this devil energy. Got the Ten of Swords, Page of Pentacles, and the Two of Cups. Just put the devil there a minute. Yeah, this person betrayed you very badly. They were backstabbing you behind your back for a long time. I mean, it could have been more than 10 years here. They were stealing from you for a long time. You know, how this energy here, I don't get it, could have could have worn a mask for so long. But what makes me laugh is the mask started to slip. You know, there's only so long that you can actually wear this mask before your true character comes out. So they were backstabbing you constantly behind your back. I do believe that they even went around laughing about you as well, pile one, to other people that they knew, that you're so gullible, you're so stupid, you're this, you're that, But what they didn't realise is they messed with the Emperor here, the Divine Masculine. And whether you're female or male, we have Divine Masculine and Feminine in all of us, okay? They didn't realise that you are protected. You are highly regarded in the spiritual world here. And they messed with the Emperor. You know, the devil went up against the Divine Masculine, who is someone who's very wise, you know. Yeah, big mistake there. And the Page of Pentacles here. This, you were dealing with someone, you're the Emperor, you were dealing with someone that is the Page. Whether they're a full-grown man or woman here, you've come out literally as a queen, you've come out as the Queen of Pentacles, Swords, Emperor. This has come, this person's come out as a devil and a page. And this is somebody that was planning behind the scenes. They were coming up with, you know, ways to manipulate you. You know, the Two of Cups, you know, this person may have told you, oh, you know, you're my soulmate, I love you. They gave you the line that you wanted to hear. And I do believe, you know, it's not your fault. You did really believe this person, but you had your eyes opened with the Queen of Swords here. And as I say, don't mess with the Queen of Swords. So let's look at their karma now. I'm going to get a different set of cards here, guys, to just find out what their karma is for. And then I'm going to use my karma cards as well. So tell me, Spirit, who is this energy's karma for hurting my pile ones? What's their karma? Eight of Wands, Four of Cups, Knight of Wands, Six of Swords, and Temperance. So the karma that I'm seeing that this person's going to receive for what they did to you, this energy here is going to be reaching out to people. It could be like, you know, maybe business ideas or wanting to go into business with someone, or just reaching out to friends, or, you know, friends of yours or whoever. But the problem is the news is not going to come. They're not going to be receiving any communication from these people, because what's going to happen is they're going to be rejecting them. People are going to be turning their back on this energy here, because they don't want nothing to do with them, because they can't be trusted. This is part of their karma. The karma is as well that people view them as someone that is very flighty, has no staying power, has no willpower, basically. You can't trust anything that this person says with the Knight of Wands. And with the Six of Swords here as well, it's moving into calmer waters. It's, you know, smooth sailing ahead, but this is not the case. This energy here is not going to be experiencing anything smooth for a long time because of what they did to you. Things are going to be rough, and I feel like it's going to be in the business sense here. You know, balance and harmony with Temperance here, but they're not going to find any balance or harmony. They're going to just find, you know, conflict, discord, you know. Yeah. Oh, well, never mind. Tell us a bit more. What's that karma? King of Wands. Tell me about this King of Wands. What's their karma? Okay. I don't need to clarify the King of Wands. King of Wands here, this person is very attractive. You know, this is the card up there. This is someone that has a way about them. And they use their good looks, because the King of Wands and the Queen of Wands are very attractive people. They've got something about them. They've got charisma. They, you know, it's just you're drawn to this person. And with the King of Wands being here, their looks are not going to help them in any situation now. It could be their looks are going to fade. You know, that could be part of their karma. They're going to age very quickly. People are not going to find them attractive. You know, there's going to be something about their aura here that people are going to steer clear of them. Eight of Pentacles, the Emperor, the Three of Wands. So with the Eight of Pentacles here, this is working on something really hard, you know, working on a career, building up your finances, working on relationships. But obviously this person is obsessed with money, because this is all I'm seeing here. I'm not seeing any love except for this here. This is all about the material world to this person. Them trying to work and build up their finances or build up a career here is not going to pay off. You know, this person thinks they go around acting like the divine masculine here, but they're really not. They're actually they're the false emperor. This is someone that is very weak minded. And I find the King of Wands as well is very weak-minded when you look at him in him or her in a different, in a negative way. You know, Three of Wands waiting for your ships to sail in. Nothing's going to be sailing in for this person. Nothing is going to be sailing in. They're literally just going to be standing on the shore looking for something to happen, but it's not going to happen because of what they did. So let's get some of my karma cards. Sorry for shaking the camera. So, Spirit, tell me what's this energy's karma. Oh, okay. We'll not be able to connect to anyone emotionally. Yeah, because they're not emotionally available anyway. I feel like with the mask that's slipping off now, people are going to start seeing the true person underneath. You know, and if you live in a small place, a small town, like I do, everybody knows everybody. Word gets around and people are just not going to trust this energy anymore. STD, so they could end up contracting something, you know. Maybe they gave you one, you part of their karma. Let's get some more. I don't know why I wrote it like that, but anyway, crap life. Meaning rubbish over here. You know, it's going to be not satisfying. I shouldn't have laughed at that. And I wanted to flip. Oh my God. This is literally a little story here. STDs and then smelly bits, you know? What happens with STDs? You get smelly bits, don't you? Yeah, I feel like they're going to get involved with the wrong person here. Is it? It looks... I feel like karma is actually affecting their looks, their bits here, because I do feel like this person does manipulate women or if, you know, men, if it's female, with their looks. So just a few more. Use for their money, so they're well, thanks Spirit, I love that. Losing friends, use for their money, which would, you know, what goes around comes around basically, doesn't it? They used you for money and were with you for only for the financial gain and not actually out of love. Reputation will be ruined. Already just said that. Word's gonna get around. Unrequited love. Maybe they're going to fall in love with someone and it's actually not going to be required, because I do believe you, Pile One, did really love this person, but it wasn't required. They will be put into a third party situation. They will always be judged by others. They're going to have legal issues. Let's just get a couple more. They'll be used for the good stuff, you know, fun stuff in the bedroom. A couple more. So it looks like this energy's karma is all to do surrounding with their appearance, with their money. They will lose everything they've worked hard for. Mental illness, I feel like they're going to suffer, because I do believe we're here with you, Pile One, where you were in the Nine of Swords and the Ten of Swords that they put you in. This is now their karma for putting you in that situation. They're going to experience that as well. Self-care, neglect. I do believe this. I feel Pile One when you... I can see it in my mind's eye now. And I shouldn't get pleasure out of it, but, you know, I'm not cruel. But I think when you next see them, okay, it could be that you may not see them for a while, but I don't know why I'm seeing this. When you next see this person, you're going to be so shocked. I feel like they're going to start balding. I see a bald head. I see a pot belly. And I just see someone that is a total mess. And you're going to be so shocked of how their whole appearance has just gone down the pan. Okay? That's what I'm seeing. They're going to be triggered in the next relationship. Well, you know, they triggered you in this relationship. It is what it is, isn't it? We've all got to experience our karma, you know. And I've had my freaking fair share of karma. I mean, sometimes I wonder, what the hell did I do? Sometimes I think, maybe did I bring it in from my previous life? But anyways, so my part one, if you like this video, please hit like and comment down below. Love to hear from you, and you take care. Hey, part two. So if you chose Jade, the Jade Heart, and the card of Blinded by Pain, I'm going to give a bit of a trigger warning here with this card. And I don't choose my cards, I shuffle, they fly out. I choose it for the piles. Well, they choose it, Spirit chooses it for the piles. So I'm just going to give a bit of trigger warning here, because this might be a sensitive subject to part my pile twos, okay? And if it's too painful, please don't stay and watch. But with this Blinded by Pain, this energy here, what they did to you was either abuse, mental abuse. They caused a lot of pain in your life, a lot of grief. They had you all up in your head. This reminds me of the Two of Swords as well as the Eight of Swords. You know, your mental health may have suffered very badly in this, you know, connection. This could even be a parent. It could be a partner. But I'll look into the energy of who this is for you guys, okay? So tell me more about this energy here that caused this Blinded by Pain from a Pile 2 spirit. Tell me more about this energy. What did they do to my... Oh, hang on. Sneaky card. Two of Wands. I'm going to take that. What that was doing in there, I don't know. Let's take that Two of Wands. That's there for a reason. I mean, how I can miss that? It's bigger than these cards. So we've got Page of Wands, High Priestess, Queen of Cups, the Sun, Nine of Wands, Six of Swords, King of Wands, the Devil. Energy on the back of the deck would explain a lot. Actually, sorry guys, I'm a bit confused. .com, yeah. Alright. So we've got Leo energy here. We've got a lot of fire energy here, and water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces as well, and Capricorn. Yeah, with it. So what I'm picking up from this energy here is that just bear with me, guys. It's like this energy promised you the world, is what I'm picking up here, you know, like a fairy tale basically. Because if you look at the cards here, I saw the Ten of Cups here, and then the Five of Cups here. I'm going to take those. And the reason I'm saying this is the path that you chose, you now know that you chose the wrong path in life with this person. They offered you the world, they offered you that the happily ever after, you know, a family, a commitment. You know, you just thought it was a fairy tale at the beginning of the relationship. I'm seeing two scenarios here, okay? It can be a relationship here, or it can be your parents here as well, because with the King and Queen of Wands, I'm picking up parent energy here as well. Now, going from the relationship aspect of it, you thought you were getting, it's very hard to get it out. I don't know whether this energy doesn't want me to talk or what, but I'm very confused, and I feel like I'm talking really fast as well, for goodness sake. Right, let me center myself a bit here. I feel like with you, pile two, the reason why I'm very confused at the moment, I'm picking up on your energy here, and this is what I'm saying about that card up there, the card that you actually picked, that the Two of Swords is confusion. The Eight of Swords is being in your head, like it's a mental health card. It's just being confused all the time, and I do feel like this energy here just made you so confused about, you know, what it is that you did wrong, what did you do, I'm picking up a lot of suffering here. You know, it could be that you've got children with this energy as well. You know, you may have started a family, because the Ten of Cups and the Sun is all about children. So children could have been a factor here, that you may have stayed longer than you needed to, you know, for the children's sake. But this person put you in the Nine of Wands. They wounded you very deeply here. You know, and it took a lot of courage for you to move away from this person here, you know, because they wounded you. I feel like you felt, you know, maybe I can't do it on my own, but I'm picking up pole two. You have moved away from this energy, because, you know, the Six of Swords is moving into calmer waters here. You've left it behind. Now we have the overall energy here of the Devil. You were dealing with someone that was so toxic, controlling, abusive, manipulative, could have gaslit you, could have been a narcissist here. Mind control is all about the Devil as well, you know, then that's what I'm getting here, because my brain is just like, I'm all over the place with your pile. And you know, the High Priestess here as well, you know, this is feel like it's your spirit guide saying to you, you did not listen to your intuition. You guys are actually very gifted, you know, you have a gift as well, but you didn't listen to the intuition. You know, you've got the Queen of Cups here with the High Priestess here. You know, these two together are someone that, you know, it's the energy of someone that is psychic, that has psychic abilities, that has their intuition is usually spot on. But I need to, you know, see, I'm all over the place. My eyes feel like they're rolling around. And the Five of Cups here as well. This is grief. This is abuse. This is neglect. This is the energy that you were in. You thought you were getting your Ten of Cups, but you actually ended up getting the Five of Cups. So, right, I need to clarify some more, because this energy is very guarded. Like, they don't want me to know what it is that they did. This is like more of how it affected you here. Tell me about this Queen of Cups. Tell me about the Queen of Cups, Holy Spirit. Can I get one? Yeah. Tell me about the Queen of Cups. Don't want to talk. King of Swords, Queen of Cups, the Tower. Yes, so you know, for some of you it can be your parents, but I'm not picking up parent vibe here. I'm picking up a relationship here between two people that were in a committed relationship. So you thought you were getting somebody, you thought when you were entering into this relationship you were getting the Queen of Cups here, which is, don't forget their energies as well, it can be male. Someone that was very loving and warm and kind, you know, sincere, you know, just someone that was just a sweetheart basically. But what you actually got, you got the King of Swords. There was a mask being worn here, like they were wearing a mask. The King of Swords is someone that was very narcissistic, very cruel. The King of Swords can be abusive as well, and that's why I'm picking up strong abuse in this connection here. A bully, they could become violent, controlling. And with the Tower, this started to be revealed to you, the true person behind the mask, if you know what I mean. It started happening very quickly as well. You started to see things happening very quickly here, because with the Chariot, that's forward movement, that's things, you know, moving quickly. And I feel like it started happening very quickly, and it was like, you know, you were shocked by this. Look, we've got the Karma card at the bottom of the deck here, well, not bottom, underneath this card here. So we've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy as well, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Capricorn. Tell me about this King of Wands. Oh, wow. Pile two. Okay. This is a friendship group here. It can be a third party. It also can be a friendship group here. So I don't know whether this was a group of people that were doing this to you. So it wasn't just... I feel like this King of Swords was getting other people involved to mistreat you, you know. I'm picking up it could have even been their family members were abusive towards you as well. You know, you were being controlled not just by your partner, but by the family as well. And they, you know, here's the Eight of Swords. They put you in the Eight of Swords here. It caused such a lot of mental tension and mental health really suffered here. You know, this is all about isolation, imprisonment, you know. Tell me about this Three of Cups. Death. Eight of Cups, Emperor, good for you. Yep, you are the divine masculine here. You know, whether you're female, you want a new, you decided that to start again and leave it all behind. You've ended this. This is ended. Thank God for your sakes, pile two. You walked away. It didn't matter whether you invested so much time. You could not put up with this no more, because, you know, you realised it wasn't good for you. If you got children, you realised it wasn't good for your children. You became the Emperor. You were in your Emperor energy when you decided to walk away from these people and this energy here of the King of Swords. You took back your control here, okay? And the Seven of Swords, to clarify, the Three of Cups here, this could have been, these people were very sneaky. They lied a lot. They could have maybe even just took fun out of the fact, you know, of maybe grassing on you to the King of Swords about things that you were doing. It could also be that the way you left as well, you became clever, you became the sneaky energy here, and I believe that's more what I'm picking up here, that you ended up manipulating everybody else, which is good for you, Palto. Love it. Absolutely love it. Let me just check out this devil energy here before I move on to the karma. Oh, didn't even ask. Strength, seven of wands, ace of pentacles. Yeah, look, you are protecting yourself from, you're protecting your new beginning from this devil energy. You don't want nothing to do with them, so your guard is up. You are protecting your brand new start here. You're looking forward to a new beginning, okay? And that's what you're doing. And you have the strength here. We've got Leo again, energy here. You're a very strong person. And I feel like this has made you strong. You know, the Emperor here, guys. You are the King of Pentacles here. This is you working on yourself. You know, it could be that you started a new job. It could be that you want to start a little business for yourself here. And it's going to do very well because you've got people that depend on you here that you need to look after. And this is someone that is very reliable, which is you guys. So let's have a look at what their karma is here. Grab those. So, Spirit, tell me, what's this energy's karma for her in my pile twos? What's their karma for her in my pile twos? All their lies is going to come out. All that they hid from other people that they did to you is going to be revealed to other people here. That's part of their karma. They're going to be in despair when this happens. They're wanting a brand new beginning here. You know, they're hoping maybe to start again with you. Look, we've got the Fool and the Pentacles again here, the Ace of Pentacles. Their karma is they would like a brand new beginning with you, okay? And I feel like their karma is that you see through their lies, you see through their deceit now, and you don't want nothing to do with this person. So they're wanting this new beginning, and it's not going to happen. And it also could be they're trying to start again, trying to move on, but it's not going to happen because the lies are going to be coming out, you know. The dark, I see this moon with this energy as their dark side, the devil, you know. So I do feel like they're going to be in some kind of despair here. Ooh. We've got the Magician, Pentacles, Two of Swords. I was going to say good, but that's not nice. But then this energy is freaking horrible. I don't like this energy at all. I feel like I can't breathe with this energy. Ooh. So anything that they want to manifest, they're not going to be able to manifest anything. They're not going to be able to manifest this new beginning that they want or manifest you back because you're blocked from them. And I do feel like that's your angels and ancestors and spirit guides that is blocking this person from you. Okay. And I also see that what I just said, all their lies, all the deceit, that they've so with the Magician, the mask that they've been wearing with everybody else, that oh, I'm Mr. Wonderful, I'm Miss Wonderful, and you know, look at me, I'm so perfect. The mask is slipping, the mask is coming off. People are going to start seeing them for who they are. They're going to be put in poverty here as well with the Five of Pentacles. This is someone's mental health that's going to suffer. And I feel like that's that part of their karma as well, because of your mental health suffered very badly here. So they're going to be struggling. Their mental health is going to be suffering as well. they're going to experience financial loss. It could be that there's going to be a health scare for them as well. Just picking up health here. And now they're in the Two of Swords. That's what I'm saying about this card here. The Two of Swords is their energy here now. With, you know, their karma. You know, they're going to be feeling confused of why is this happening to me. I don't think they even realise why it's happening. I feel like this person's got such a big ego that they can't see why it's happening. And all the times that they backstabbed you, all the times that they betrayed you, um, this is going to happen to them. They're going to be hitting rock bottom. They're going to experience rock bottom. This is not good karma for this person. Oh, jeez. Look at karma. Justice. So with the Justice card here, this is karma. This is balancing the scales. It's putting right what was done wrong. So I feel like a lot of people now are going to be... I know you shouldn't take sides, but I do believe that they are going to start taking sides. They are going to start seeing what this person did to you. And people are going to start turning their back on them. This person's going to become very isolated. People are not going to want to, you know, have anything to do with them. They're not going to want to socialise with them. So, yeah, they're going to become very isolated as well. Look, people are walking away from this person. People want nothing to do with them because of their sneaky ways, because of the way they treated you. They're going to have to juggle their finances here. Could end up suffering because of the Five of Pentacles as well. So they're going to have to juggle... quite a bit. King of Cups and Queen of the Ace of Cups here. So with the karma is people may have seen this person as the King of Cups. You know, we've got the couple here, charming, sweet, sincere, you know, just someone that loves their partner and is very genuine about it. But they're going to start seeing that the real person is someone who is emotionally abusive, someone who is uncaring, someone that is just overall not a nice person. And they're really hoping for a second chance at love, you know, to do it again with someone. But the divine is saying you ain't getting your second chance at love. I feel like there's no second chance here for this person. Not for a while. So let's get some karma cards from my deck. Reputation will be ruined, which we've already seen. No success in anything, which we've already seen. With the Five of Pentacles. So what's their karma spirit for hurting my lovely jubbly pile toes? No spiritual protection, which I could have said that with the Magician here. I feel like they've really peed off their spiritual team here, and yours as well. Stopped by the police for traffic tickets. It could be just being stopped, traffic tickets, you know, things just not going their way. They'll always be judged by others, which we've seen. I do feel like there is going to be sides taken here. I feel like they are going to be judged. Don't people going to trust these people? Dreams will come true, but will quickly turn into hell. Actually, give me a minute, guys. Hang on. That has just done something with this. I'm wondering, let me see, if this person's involved with someone or getting involved with someone, whether this is what's going to happen here, that they're... clarify the Ace of Cups. I know what I'm saying here and I'll explain it after. Tell me about the Ace of Cups. What's the karma here for the Ace of Cups? Tell me about the Ace of Cups. Yeah, I thought so. Justice again. Wow. So this is their karma here, guys. I feel like they want us. They may be interested in someone else right now. They may want another chance to start again with somebody else here. Now, what I'm seeing here with the Strength, I'm seeing someone that will be defeated in this, that it's not going to work out how they thought it was going to work out. And what's going to happen is that it's going to cause a lot of burdens with the Ten of Wands here. Because, you know, they can try and run away from what they did to you, but it's always going to be there. It's always going to be haunting them. And I feel like this is what their karma is. And I do feel like the next person they get involved with is going to put them in the energy of the Ten of Wands. I wanted to burp. Sorry. You know, they're going to experience stress, exhaustion. They're going to have a lot of responsibilities. But this is karmic justice here with the justice card there. Love it. So what's their karma for hurting my pile twos? Rejection. Valuables will be stolen. That's, we have the seven of swords there as well. That's someone stealing something. Toxic relationships, which just come out there. Mental illness, which we've seen. Blocked finances, which we've already seen. And undesirability, where people will not find them attractive because they must be see through their true self. So, my lovely pile twos, I hope this resonated for you. If it did, please hit like, comment down below. Love to hear from you, and you take care. Bye. Hey, pile three, so if you chose Amethyst here, and the card Naked Before the Stars. So with this card, it speaks of a relationship that went sour, a relationship that could have turned toxic. This person made you feel vulnerable, you know, exposed. So let's have a look more into what this, who this energy is and what they did to you. So tell me more about this energy here. What did they do to my palfrey's spirit? Aquarius energy, Ten of Pentacles. A few more. Tell me more about this situation. Six of Cups, Nine of Wands, Five of Cups, Knight of Pentacles. Is the Two of Cups and the Lovers as well on the back of the deck. Okay, this is a strong relationship or connection that I'm picking up here for you guys, which clarifies the Naked Before the Stars. So we have I didn't fart, that was my foot on my chair. So I don't know if you heard that, but just in case you sit there thinking, oh my god, did she just fart? Anyway, I see what's happened here. My pile three. Oh, so the Naked Before the Stars, I feel like you were in love with this person. You offered yourself up naked, if you know what I mean, but not literally in the sense of you standing there naked or in your underwear, because she's in her underwear, but you were so open with this person. You know, they could see how much you loved them and how much, you know, how vulnerable you were. And what I'm picking up here is that this energy here, I don't feel like this energy is toxic at all, but I feel like they made a big mistake because they overlooked you. It could have been that you were young and, or just not fully mature yet, or it's like they overlooked you. They didn't see you for who you were and they chose somebody else here. They went down the road of thinking about themselves, you know, their future with the Ten of Pentacles, you know, because I feel like I feel like you couldn't bring to the table what they were wanting with somebody else here. You know, they chose someone that they could build up they've chose somebody else that they could have the Ten of Pentacles with, a family, children, you know, wealth, success, and that's what they followed. You know, they followed their heart here. This is someone, the reason why I'm saying this could be someone that you knew when you were younger here, and they chose someone different, because we have the Six of Cups here. This is you know, I find this card to me is like childhood sweethearts or you just being younger than them. You know, and it was an innocent kind of love here. But I'm getting strong vibes here that they chose somebody else over you. You know, they felt, maybe they felt like that they were choosing their soulmate here with the Two of Cups here. They made a choice with the Lovers as well. You know, they chose somebody over you. But what I'm picking up here, guys, is that this didn't go very well for this person. They put materialistic things in front of actual genuine love and overlooked you here, and all it causes them is to be wounded, you know, burdened by this. They've had a lot of heartache, a lot of hardships in their life as well. They didn't realize, and I think they've realized now, is that you are the divine feminine here. You know, you are the Empress. And I feel like you haven't seen this person for a very long time, and I feel like they're just getting their karma now, which is very weird. It's been a long time since that there's, like, you know, distance between both of you. There's coldness between both of you. There's just no, there's no communication here. And they turned their back on you and they left you out in the cold here, and it, you know, and I feel like you have grieved a lot over the loss of this energy here. You know, I feel like it still affects you today, even if, you know, you're much older and it's been years. You know, you were offering them love here, you know, genuine love here, and I feel like they overlooked you as their soulmate and the divine feminine here. They just totally just didn't see it because they were concentrating on the Ten of Pentacles here. I feel like this person did go on to marry this person, have children with them, with the Empress here as well. Oh, my hair. So let's have a look. I mean, the Empress, let me clarify her, because it could even be the person they got involved with. Tell me more about the Empress. Who is this? Who's the Empress? Tell me more about the Empress and the Palfrey spirit, please. Bear with me, guys. Yeah, they now realise they're in the Ten of Pentacles, the Ten of Swords here. They're all up in their head in regards to you here, that they didn't realise that you were someone very special. You know, you can't get no more special than the Empress here. They now realise that you were offering them this genuine cup of love here, and they rejected you. You know, they decided to call it a day, go down a different path with judgment here. This is someone that's feeling very guilty, or, you know, constantly thinking about how they did you dirty, or the regret. I'm just picking up huge regret here. It's like they've finally had this wake-up call. I don't know whether their ancestors or somebody or their spirit guides are like now poking the bear, if you know what I mean, to make them realise the mistake that they made. The this person has nightmares about this, or they have dreams about you. They stay awake late at night thinking about you as well. Let's have a look. So tell me more about this person that hurt my paraphrase. A bit more. They see how valuable you are now. I mean, maybe this person keeps an eye on you. Maybe they spy on your social media and you're not aware of... We've got the Wheel of Fortune, which is karma. Maybe they are now aware that you are the Queen of Pentacles and how valuable you actually was. And, you know... And I feel like this person's actually realised that you could have brought a lot of peace into their life, but they've experienced a lot of karma, and I do believe it's because they chose wrong. They didn't follow the path that they were supposed to go down, which was with you. So they've experienced a lot of hardships here with the Wheel of Fortune. Tell me about the Nine of Wands. Yeah, they ended up with a Queen of Wands here. Yep, look. Wow. So the Ace of Swords is the truth and clarity. It's something that is being revealed, or the truth is coming out. So when they chose the Queen of Wands, they were very attracted to this Queen of Wands. I feel like it was quite sexual between both of them, because we've got the Knight of Wands here. So I feel like there was a lot of sexual chemistry between both of them. And there was something just about the Queen of Wands that they were attracted to. But in reality, what they actually got with the Nine of Wands here was somebody that... they didn't meet up to the expectation that they were expecting here. They ended up with someone that is, I don't like the Queen of Wands when she's seen in a negative way. She's someone that's very pushy. She could be a bully. She could be very unfriendly towards people. She's got a mean, jealous streak in her. Very spiteful, very manipulative as well. And this has wounded this energy. And this is the truth that's finally come out and been revealed to this person. You know, that's part of their karma here. You know, if you chose wrong, you know, that could be why they're getting their, you know, maybe the Queen of Wands is their karma. So what more does my pile friends need to know? So we've got the Devil, Eight of Swords, the Hierophant, Knight of Cups. So we've got Capricorn energy here, we've got fire sign energy here, and earth sign as earth energy as well, guys. Now, with the Devil, this person could have addictions, could have ended up just trying to bury themselves in just, you know, toxic ways, alcohol, drugs, you know, that kind of thing. I feel like they've ended up with some kind of addiction here, and their mental health is suffering very badly at the moment with this, because of these addictions. It's like they feel trapped. They feel there's no way out of this situation. You know, they've invested like a long time with this person. It's like they're just trapped. They're trapped with the Devil, basically. These two are actually married. I do believe the Queen of Wands is married to this, well, the Devil's married, you know what I mean. And they look back on what they could have had with you. You know, they didn't see that you were the star, basically. and now they're all lit up. I don't think this person can take any more karma, to be honest. Why is the Knight of Cups here with the Eight of Wands? Is this somebody? Is this someone that wants to communicate to you that they have romantic feelings for you? Or it could be that they are still harbouring romantic feelings towards you and they would like to communicate this to you. Let's have a look. Tell me about the Knight of Cups and the Eight of Wands here. Yeah, this person's still harbouring a lot of feelings for you guys. You know, this is like a wake-up call. It's like this has just been... I feel like this person still thought about you over the years, but I feel like that's really, really like just hit them now, you know? Oh, my God. No, spirit. Seriously, we'll be here all day. Tell me about the Knight of Cups and the Eight of Wands. Why are these here? Tell me why they... Right, guys, I'm going to do that again because that was a bit of a bugger up. Tell me about the Knight of Cups and the Ace of Wands. Maybe they don't want to tell me. No. Tell me about the Knight of Wands and the Knight of Cups and the Ace of Wands, please, Spirit. Oh, do you know what? Whatever, I'm taking them. We'll be here all day. Sun, the Fool, the Pentacle, Six of Pentacles. Okay. They now realise that you are their happiness with the Sun card here. They've had like an epiphany moment. Like I said, they've had a realisation that you were their happiness this whole time. And I feel like they sit in the dark though and do this. I feel like they look at old pictures of you guys together. I feel like they do still have photos of both of you together. It could even be if you wrote, you know, letters or texts or something like that, that they sit there at night time and they look at this and it brings them a lot of grief here, of what they could have had with you. You know, they realise that you brought them a lot of joy. But it's like they now want this. It's like this is a different kind of reading for you guys. That this is like literally a very nice energy that's made a mistake here. But they're trying to say to you, it's like they're coming through saying to you that they would like to start again. They would like to take a chance with you again if they could get the opportunity to do this. They would like it to be equal this time. They'd like to give to you this time without being selfish, you know, and thinking about themselves. But they're in the Two of Swords at the moment, and the Two of Swords is being in confusion and conflict here. It's like they don't, you know, they don't know how to approach you, or maybe they don't know where you are, maybe because they're still in maybe they're still with the Queen of Wands. Let me get some advice for you. Like, what advice would you give my paraphrase? Tell me about the High Priestess. So this is all about secrets. Trust your intuition here. Maybe their intuition's been telling them to reach out and to approach you. Maybe your intuition has been telling you that you're going to hear from this person. Yeah, it could be that because they are still in their commitment here with the Four of Wands, it could be that they can't, they're going to have to juggle both. And I think Spirit's telling you to use your intuition if this person does approach you with a message, just to be careful. Let me just clarify the Four of Wands. Oh, I can't believe this reading's gone like this. This is very weird. Yeah, look, okay. Listen to your intuition, my pile freeze here. There's a warning here with the Seven of Swords. This person's still involved. They could come back and say to you, oh, my marriage is all crap and and I want to leave them and we're on the verge of leaving, but it's not true. They're being sneaky about this. And it could even be that they're going to be sneaky about the way they contact you as well, so that the Queen of Wands doesn't know about it. Because the Seven of Swords is a very sneaky energy here. I knew there was a warning in here somewhere. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Yeah, look, secrets, illusions, defeat. There's whatever. This energy here is being selfish, basically. They can't have their cake and eat it here. They're still involved with somebody, even though they now have this epiphany that, oh my God, it was you, my pal Fred, that I should have been with. But there's still a lot of secrets. It's an illusion. It's not, I don't feel like you can trust this energy at all. And Spirit is telling you, your best bet is to just walk away from this and not, admit that it's just never going to go anywhere. So now let's find out their karma for what they did. I feel like we've already sort of seen it, really. So what's this energy's karma for hurting my pile three? Page of Wands, Ten of Cups, Nine of Cups, Four of Wands again. God, I need a toilet. Too much coffee. Eight of Wands. Okie dokie. So basically, this energy's karma for what they did to you is that, they were being selfish, they were thinking about themselves, it was all about me. And they thought, that things were going to go very well for them. Okay, they wanted this, they were very passionate about this Queen of Wands, they're very passionate about this and excited about this new beginning that they were going to get with them. They got married with the Four of Wands. They're in this committed relationship here. They've got the Ten of Cups and the Nine of Cups here. They saw this person as wish fulfillment, saw them as their happily ever after. But what they got was the Ten of Wands. They've got a lot of burdens. They got the Queen of Wands again. Sorry, I shouldn't laugh, but whatever. Yeah, with this relationship here, this commitment that they made to this Queen of Wands, they didn't get the Nine of Cups or the Ten of Cups or the Four of Wands. They got unhappiness, basically. It wasn't a wish fulfilled. It wasn't happily ever after. With the Ten of Wands, it's all about burdens. Feeling stressed, exhausted by this Queen of Wands. I think a lot of responsibility gets put on this energy here with the Ten of Wands. I feel like maybe the Queen of Wands doesn't work, relies on them for financial stability, emotional security, that kind of thing. Why is the death here?
Dog's moaning.
Yeah, this brought about a big change with the death here. And a bad change as well. They're in a bad situation here. They felt like they're going to end it with you, but it brought about a bad situation and a bad a bad change, basically. So tell me, what's their karma for hurting my pile three? For hurting my pile three, Spirit. The karma is, we've got the Two of Cups again. The karma is, they now know that you were their soulmate, okay? They now know that you could have been their twin flame, because we've had two Four of Wands come out as well, that I feel like you are their twin flame as well, but we'll go by the soulmate here. Now, they now know that their feelings for you were actually, were more than what they thought. I feel like they thought, I feel like they were thinking with their privates, basically, when they got involved with the Queen of Wands, because she's very sexy, she's very attractive, she uses her body to get what she wants, you know, that kind of thing, that kind of manipulation there. And their karma is as well, because they're in a marriage here with the Four of Coins, is it's not letting go. It's not, this Queen of Wands is not letting this energy go. There's no way out of this. They're stuck. This Queen of Wands is very possessive over this energy here. And I just feel like there's no getting out of, look, King of Wands as well, that's a couple. It's just no getting out of this situation for them. Tell me more about their karma. Queen of Swords, Queen of Three of Wands, Two of Wands. So their karma is here is that this relationship that they're in, this marriage, there's a lot of coldness towards one another. They don't feel attracted towards this Queen of Wands anymore. If anything, they try and avoid the Queen of Wands, here. You know, they thought they were getting someone, you know, I've already described the Queen of Wands as being a bit of a, not a very nice person, and with the Queen of Swords as well, this is someone that can be very malicious and cruel. Someone that's very obsessive with this energy here, and that's why I said they're not wanting to let go of this person. You know, this energy here is really pining, yearning for you. You know, they're looking out on the horizon to find an opportunity to maybe make their way back to you, but there is no way back to you here because they're stuck in this situation here. They want to choose a different path, but their karma is, you're stuck now. You chose this path. This is the path you are on. So let's get some of my karma cards and see what their karma is. So basically, the karma for this person here is, you know, they rejected you. They didn't realize you were the divine feminine here, and now their whole relationship here is literally just a shite show, basically. You know, they may have the material wealth here, but I don't believe they do. I feel like they've had a lot of problems with money over the years. Maybe this person, when they decided to marry them, had, you know, financial security, you know. Maybe if it was some kind of arranged marriage, they came with, you know, like back in the day with camels and horses and stuff. I shouldn't laugh. But, you know, that was back in the day, you know, in the olden days, you know. So it could have been that kind of situation, but maybe not horses and camels. But you know what I mean, pile three. So let's look at their karma. I don't know why I said that, but anyway. Oh, camels spiritually means someone that's in it for the long haul, someone that's there for a long time. So that could be why I said camels. And horses like to be free, don't they? And this person wants to be free, but they're stuck. So what's this person's karma for hurting my pile threes? They're going to age quickly, but that could be the drug and alcohol addiction that they've got themselves into to block out this person that they're with. Sometimes I don't blame people. Crap life. We'll not be able to find a job. We'll not be able to forget you. Thanks, spirit. I love that. Losing friends. And I do believe you. I feel like you guys, okay, with the High Priestess that came out, and I do believe, look, my path is, you have a gift, okay? You're someone that's very special, spiritually protected. You're the divine feminine as well. And I believe that people that actually hurt my pole threes, they could do anything to you, and your spiritual team gets involved. So you are people's karma, my pole three. That's what I'm picking up strongly with this reading here. And the reason being they can't forget you is because that's their karma. They're always haunted by you with the nine, you know, look, the Nine of Swords. And they can't forget you. You are the karma. So some people need to watch my pile phrase, you know. You could do some, any little thing. Use for their money, which I said, I feel like that's why the Queen of Wands does not want to let this energy go. It's because of financial stability. No wishes will come true. The partner will cheat. So they could be dealing with a cheater. It's quite sad, really. What's their karma for hurting the pile three spirit? Legal issues. Right, what have we got? People will stab them in the back, so they can't trust anyone. No genuine friends, which losing friends, no genuine friends. They will always be judged by others. Look what's on the back of the deck, guys. They will be constantly reminded of you. So I do believe wherever this person goes, I think something just reminds them of you. I just feel like they're just going to be haunted by you, which is very sad, you know. But anyway, like I said, if they're stuck in this situation that's to do with money, you know, with the generational wealth here, it could be that that's more important to them than actually breaking away from the Queen of Wands. So anyway, so if you like this reading, guys, please hit like, subscribe if you're new, please comment down below. Love hearing from you guys, and you take care and have a wonderful day. Bye.